showing you, or I will be showing you, the PlayStation 4 games that I just recently purchased off of Amazon. Now, these are games that I actually had before, and last December, when I sold 80% of my video game collection, these went into them. So, the app that I use to track what games I have, what games I need to get, I needed these again. So, some of them are the same game, they're just a variant of that game. And as we go through, I'll point out what I mean by that for those of you who don't really know what I'm talking about, but you'll see as we go through. Some of these games are pretty bad, some of these games are really good, and obviously some are in between. But I apologize for some of the dog hair that are on these. Now, these are all sealed, and they probably will continue to stay that way unless I choose to play them. There's a few that I'll point out that I will most likely play at some point. But right now, I'm in the middle of Assassin's Creed Valhalla. And after that, I have to play Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memory and Streets of Rage 4. And Cobra Kai, and then I may have some free time to play other things, but until then, these will stay sealed. But what we're gonna do first is I'm gonna go over something that's video game related that I just picked up, but is not a game itself. It is a brand new Figpin from Figpin. It's number 256, and it's the new Spyro one that just got released. So, there you go. And that's what it looks like. I have to put this into my Spyro collection, or my Figpin collection on my phone, the app, so I can keep track of this and scan. There's this place you can scan the barcode here, and it tracks which ones you have. So I wanted to get this out of the way. Alright, first up, we have Ghostbusters. Now, this is not the remastered version. I have that already. This is the game that was based on the female Ghostbuster team. And actually, I'm wrong. This is not based on the female team. This is just a brand new Ghostbusters game with random people. This has nothing to do with the females, actually. But it's a mixture. You have guys and girls. And it says, grab your proton pack and become a Ghostbuster. Battle many ghosts, including Slimer, Gertrude Aldridge, and more. Capture ghosts in four-player co-op. Swap from the classic proton pack to unique character weapons and grenades. So, we have Ghostbusters. This was not a good game. I think it got a 5.5 or a 6.5 out of 10 in Game Informer when it came out. But anyway, I'm a Ghostbuster fan, so therefore I have to have it. Now, next up is a classic game, and this is one of the variants I was talking about earlier. I already have the collector's edition. It's actually called the Stonemason edition of the game. And so I have the game already. I've already played the game. So there's no reason for me to ever open what I'm about to show you. Same with Ghostbusters, by the way. This will never be opened. But this is the PlayStation Hits variant of God of War. And this game, I remember playing when it came out. And I did not like it in the first hour. I was not what I was used to. I just didn't like it. But then as I started playing it, I fell in love with it. And it is probably one of the best games I've ever played of all time. God of War is a great series. I've played every game in the series with the exception of the mobile phone game that I did not know about. And then it's too late now to obviously download it. It wouldn't run on brand new phones, but living as a man outside the shadow of the gods, Kratos, along with his son Atreus, must venture into the brutal Norse wilds as they fight to fulfill a deeply personal quest. Discover an emotionally gripping tale of father and son. Journey to a dark, elemental world of fearsome creatures. Conquer your foes in vicious close quarters combat. This was a great game, and one of the hardest boss fights I've ever played in my life was the last Valkyrie. Oh my god, was she hard. I mean, it took me a million tries, and I'll never forget it. I probably tried 50 times. I shut the console off, and then the next day I went back at it, and within, I think, 2 tries I beat her, and I recorded it. It's on my old phone, my Galaxy 9 or 10, Galaxy S. I forget which one it is, but I still have the ending. I sent it to my former boss, who was playing the game also. So anyway, that will stay sealed because I've already played the game, beaten it, and there's no reason to open that copy. Now, this game is going to stay sealed because I've already played all of the games that are on this disc. I had the collector's edition of this, and I'm pissed that I don't know what happened to it. I thought I had it, but maybe I still do. I'll have to check. I'll double check. But this is the regular version of the game. And if I still have the collector's edition version of this game, then there's no reason to ever open this again, because the collector's edition is opened. But this is Kingdom Hearts HD 2.8 Final Chapter Prologue. And in this game, you were able to play a snippet of a prequel before Kingdom Hearts 3 started, but you also learned about the Foretellers and who they were. And these Foretellers were at one point the main characters in Kingdom Hearts Union Cross. And so there's a huge movie that you can watch about, you know, who they are and their relation to the Master of Masters, and one of them is a traitor and we don't know who, and it turns out that one of them at the end of Kingdom Hearts 3 ended up being Zigbar from the Organization 13. So that was a pretty cool reveal, but that was in Kingdom Hearts 3, not this version. But anyway, here you have 3 magical experiences, the evolution in Kingdom Hearts graphics. So, Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance HD, remastered and on PlayStation for the first time. This was a 3DS exclusive release, and I remember playing this. I think it came out in 2012. That's how old this game is. I didn't really like it, but the mechanics were a little not my style. Then we have Kingdom Hearts 0.2 Birth by Sleep, A Fragmentary Passage, New Adventure in the Dark World. You play as Aqua, and you're in the darkness, the void, and you're trying to figure out how to get out. And then Kingdom Hearts Key Back Cover, new HD cinematic revealing a story untold. So these are have to do with the Foretellers and, you know, the Keyblade War, the first Keyblade War, not the one where Xehanort won, but this one. It was the first ever one. So that's that. That'll stay sealed, as well as this one will stay sealed because I have the collector's edition version of this game, and we have Kingdom Hearts 3. This game pissed me off. I waited, and a lot of people waited almost 15 years for this to be released. You have no idea. I was 22 when the second main game came out, 2004. And I loved Kingdom Hearts 2. Kingdom Hearts 2 was so dark and so adult. And then this came out. Graphically, it was beautiful. This game is beautiful graphically. But I got bored playing this game, and that shouldn't happen. And some people will say, well, you're 36 now. It was 12 years ago. Wait a minute. I wasn't 22 in 2014. I was 20. That makes more sense. I was 20 in 2014. I'm 36 now, and this game finally came out. I was 35 when it came out. It came out in 2019, but I got bored playing it, and the ending is one of the worst endings in the history of life, and I don't want to spoil it for those who haven't played this game, but you know what? By now, you should have. It's been out almost 2 years, so basically, Xehanort and Sora face off in a final battle. Sora wins. And Master Ericus was hiding in Terra's heart after we all thought he was dead. When Xehanort killed him, he hid in Terra's heart, and at the last second he escapes Terra. And he pops out, and everyone's like, oh my god, there's Master Ericus. And Master Ericus looks at Xehanort and looks at him and goes, hey, buddy, just let's give up now, okay? And Xehanort goes, yeah, alright, I'll give up. And that's it. And then they both float into the sky because they're dead. It was the most ridiculous, you know what I mean? I was so angry. Now, having said that, the hidden ending, Yuzora, looks really cool. Where the series is going to go looks really exciting. I know Kingdom Hearts Melody of Memory extends the story a smidgen. It's from Kairi's point of view. So it'll be interesting to see what nuggets we pick up, but it's not really going to have any earth-shattering information, which I'm kind of disappointed about. But we'll see what happens with Kingdom Hearts 4 and how long it takes for that to be released. But this was a very disappointing game. Very disappointing. Next up, this will be opened at some point. We have Mega Man Legacy Collection. And it has all six original Mega Mans on this cartridge, on this disc, I should say, the CD. So you have Mega Man, Mega Man 2, Mega Man 3, Mega Man 4, Mega Man 5, and Mega Man 6. Six games in one, including a new challenge mode that remixes levels for a new gaming experience. Museum mode features sketches, concept art, and more. So I will eventually open this and play Mega Man. I've always wanted to play the original Mega Man's in completion, and I will try to do that at some point. Likewise, our next game is Mega Man Legacy Collection 2. And this has 7, 8, 9, and 10. Additional features include Remix Challenge Mode, Mega Man History Museum, and online leaderboards. So this will be cool to be able to play these. And finally, in the Mega Man series, we have Mega Man Legacy X Collection and Mega Man X Legacy Collection 2. this has Mega Man X, Mega Man X2, Mega Man X3, Mega Man X4, Mega Man X5, Mega Man X6, Mega Man X7, Mega Man X8, the Ultimate Mega Man X Collection. X Challenge Mode, fight two bosses at once. These are new features. Online leaderboards, compete against the world. Mega Man X Archives, tons of rare production art, promo videos, and more. The Day of, I don't know what that stands for, animated prequel film. So, these are going to be exciting to play at some point. Now, next up is a game that is a sequel, kind of, to a Sega Genesis game that came out a long time ago. And it's one of the, it's a very rare complete in box Sega Genesis game to find. You could probably pay upwards of $100 for it. But it's Mutant Football. And this is Mutant Football League Dynasty Edition, which includes all DLC and exclusive teams and arenas from Nighthawk Interactive. If the fields don't kill you, the players will. Mutants and monsters unleash maniacal carnage on the gridiron in this action-packed arcade-style football game. Mutant Football League Dynasty Edition delivers online multiplayer action, big hits, deep strategy, and deadly humor. It says just kill it. You got online play, multiplayer, dynasty, franchise, full season, 25 teams, dirty tricks, and these characters are, what's the word I'm looking for? Satires, I guess, is the not the right word, but they're satires on real players. So, for example, this is Wham Newton, Wham Neutron, supposed to be Cam Newton. Oh Hell Wreckham would be Odell Beckham. Von Killer is Von Miller. Bomb Shady is Tom Brady. Slay Wrathspew is Clay Matthews. Despawn Rotsam is Deshaun Watson. And Throb Bronkowski is Rob Gronkowski. So, there's Mutant Football League. I don't know if I'll ever open this. It's a big maybe. Okay, next is a puzzle game that I originally had the collector's edition for the Switch, and unfortunately, I thought I had kept it, but it ended up going in the sale, and it came with a keychain and a little plush something, I think, and I'm not going to go and get the collector's edition of the game, but I did buy the PlayStation 4 just regular version, and it's Puyo Puyo Tetris. It's an official Tetris product. And it's Frantic four-player puzzle mashup from Sega. And I don't think I'll ever open this. I'm a huge Tetris fan. I try to collect every Tetris game there ever is or was. But we'll see. This is the ultimate puzzle showdown. Play Puyo Puyo versus mode. Play Tetris versus mode. Play Puyos and Tetrominos on the same board. Up to four players can compete locally and online. First-timers, don't fear. Learn to play Puyo Puyo and Tetris in lesson mode. And if you're playing solo, conquer adventure mode, survive an endurance match, or take on the solo arcade challenges. So Puyo Puyo Tetris. Okay, next up is Sonic Forces. I will at some point open this. I still haven't even completed Sonic Mania. I have the collector's edition for the PS4 that came with the Sega Genesis little, you know, collector's system where it turns on and you hear the Sega noise. But I have not played a lot of the Sonic games. I think the last Sonic game I really ever played, with the exception of Sonic Mania, was Sonic 3D Blast. That's how far back I am. And I hated Sonic 3D Blast. I don't think I ever finished it. It was a hard game, but it was boring. This game did not get good reviews. I think it was passed. passable at best. But it says, join the uprising. The evil Dr. Eggman has taken control of the world. Now you must defeat iconic old villains and fight a powerful new enemy to reclaim the world in this epic new adventure. Hit blazing speeds as modern Sonic, platform as classic Sonic, and create your custom hero and fight with powerful gadgets. So, we have Sonic Forces. And I take that back. I actually did play Sonic Adventure on the Dreamcast. I just never got into the game. From what I've been told, it's one hell of a game. It's probably the last good Sonic game. People said Sonic Adventure 2 was okay, but it was not like the first one. It was worse, but it was still passable. And then everything with Sonic 06, everyone likes to call it, and I think the angry video game nerd really went in on depth on that game. It was the downfall, really, of Sonic at that point. All right, next up is a fighting game. This is another variant. I have the collector's edition of this fighting game. I am a big fan of this fighting series, but I was not a fan of the recent entry. It was okay, but very frustrating, and the game is Soul Calibur 6. It's better than Dead or Alive 6, don't get me wrong. Dead or Alive 6 was a huge disappointment in my opinion. But here it says, bring more than your fists to the fight. You have two story modes. Experience the epic tale of the legendary Soul Swords. Over 20 iconic warriors and all new characters, each with their own unique weapon, fighting style, and visual flair. New battle systems. Utilize innovative all-new battle mechanics to destroy your opponents. And this was an interesting release because a lot of people made it seem, I did not realize this was a reboot of the entire series. I thought it was a continuation, but I guess it's not. I think it's a more in-depth story to the original Soul Blade, really, but I did not realize it. I read a review, I think, in Game Informer where it basically called it a reboot, or I read an article somewhere that called this a reboot, and apparently it was well known that this was what this was, but when playing it, I didn't really realize that at the time, so it was a good game. It wasn't a great game. I still, to this day, think Soul Calibur, either 2 or 3, I forget which it is the best in the series. It's the one where you literally, I think it's 3. 3 had like this tactical RPG mode where you literally went around a board and tried to, you know, conquer lands before they conquered you. And each move was you had a... make sure that you were there before the computer was, and all this other stuff. So I still think it's 3, I think, is my favorite of all time because of that mode. But Soul Calibur for the Dreamcast is one of the best fighting games of all time, in my opinion. So there's that. Next up, and this will probably stay sealed, but we have Team Sonic Racing. Gear up, speed up, team racing at Sonic speed. Experience high-speed arcade and online competitive team racing across stunning worlds, the ultimate race to victory. Single-player, split-screen, and online multiplayer modes. Battle together to unleash your team ultimate boost. Customize your vehicle and race as your favorite Sonic character. And finally, we have two variants of this fighting game, and I have the collector's edition also of this fighting game, and these two will never be opened because the collector's edition already is, and I've already installed it and played the game. But here we have Tekken 7. Graphically, this is the best game in the entire series. Graphics are incredible. Hilariously enough, though, this was one of the hardest Tekken games I've ever played. The final boss, Akuma, is extraordinarily hard, at least for me. But we have The Best Fights Are Personal, the best-selling fighting game franchise returns. Over 35 iconic fighters and all new characters experience the epic cinematic story mode. Now, I don't think I've beaten the game with every character, and the reason for that is I don't think there's endings with each character. You just beat them. There's no story for each person. Not even text, if I'm not mistaken. So, not only was it extremely hard, but there was no real reason to even attempt to try to fight and beat the game with every character like in other versions. Even if there was no real cinematic ending to each character, there was at least some text screens that had little snippets of, you know, story. But with this one, when I beat it a couple of times, there was nothing. There was just credits. So I don't really get it. And then the next version of Tekken 7 is called Tekken 7 Day 1 Edition. And I really don't know the difference. Let's take a look and see what it says. Oh, here we go. Okay. So here, the Day 1 Edition includes Eliza, which is a bonus DLC character. That's the only difference between the two. This comes with Eliza, whereas the original version does not. So, that's that. And then the last game is actually for the PlayStation 5, and it is a sequel to one of the games here on this list. And again, this will most likely stay sealed as well, because the other one is sealed and will stay sealed. But this is Puyo Puyo Tetris 2, the ultimate puzzle match. And here, it has launch edition bonus, exclusive new mode add-on content, includes 3 Sonic the Hedgehog item cards. Well, that's interesting. Sonic the Hedgehog's in here. Let's take a look. So the ultimate puzzle match, it's an interdimensional puzzle delight when Japan's beloved series Puyo Puyo and the world-famous Tetris franchise blend their legendary gameplay together. Traditional and crossover gameplay, all new story adventure, brand new skill battle mode, competitive and casual play online. So, PlayStation 5, Puyo Puyo Tetris 2. Now, this also came out for the PlayStation 4, but there was no reason for me to buy the PS4 version when I can have the upgraded next-gen version. So, I don't know if there's a difference really graphically, but I'd rather have the newer version for the same money, or $5 more, whatever. So, and there you have it, guys. We have 15 games. And we also have the Spyro Figpin as well. Well, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you liked the video. Tried out a new mic. Hopefully the sound is better. Please leave your comments in the section below. I want to get better at making videos for you guys.